Friends, I am one of you and have been associated with you all as a member of the Indian Orthopedic Association and its various state chapters in various capacities now almost nearly for the last 35 years. It may be teaching, like participation in postgraduate courses, instruction courses of the Indian Orthopedic Association, continuing orthopedic education programs, various hands-on workshops, cadaveric courses, and nevertheless, public awareness programs of the Indian Orthopedic Association. I have taken an uphill task to contest the post of Vice President of the Indian Orthopedic Association because I want to work for the welfare of the members of our esteemed association, and I am here to seek your vote, support, and good wishes. I have a vision to see Indian Orthopedic Association as the best association in the world, and I am sure by this time, my vision document must be in your hands. To meet this goal, I will digitalize the office of the Indian Orthopedic Association, strengthen it, use technology and resources, and register all the practicing orthopedic surgeons of the country and bring them under the umbrella of IOA as a united front. There is a question. Yes, there is a question. Yes, please, tell me.
Sir, how will you manage the finances for running an e-library?
Oh, yes. It's an excellent question. You see, there are 30,000 practicing orthopedic surgeons in this country. All are not registered. We have only 11,500 orthopedic surgeons registered as members of the association. So if we register 1,000 orthopedic surgeons, this will earn us an interest of 3,33,000 rupees per annum. And if the association is able to award membership to 5,000 doctors, we will earn an interest of 17 lakh rupees per annum. And similarly, if we put in our efforts and register additional 20,000 orthopedic surgeons, which are not members as of now, the association will earn an interest of 67 lakh rupees per annum. I think this money is enough to manage the affairs of an e-library and also to create and maintain the orthopedic registry of the association. That is how we can make the Indian Orthopedic Association a research-oriented scientific body, and that's the dream of many of my friends, and I would like to fulfill this dream of all of you. Are you satisfied?
Yes, sir.
Yes. The profession is passing through a turmoil. The doctors are being assaulted every day. And we have to set the things in order as far as our work culture is concerned. I want to ask you a question. Have you heard of assault on doctors in UK and USA? No, because the health delivery system in these countries is very well organized. I will, as a president of the Indian Orthopedic Association, impress upon the government to make health delivery system effective. We have to participate in public awareness programs. We should take steps in the prevention of diseases. We should carry people with us. And I am sure by taking these two measures, there will be no more assault on the doctors. It has been my desire to bring youth again under one umbrella of Indian Orthopedic Association and create a youth forum. Yes, you are right to ask me a question, how I will channelize the energies of the youth for a better IOA. I will create a youth forum to address the grievances of our young orthopedic surgeons. I shall enter into an exchange program for their upgradation of the knowledge. Friends, we have an annual budget of 14 crore rupees for one conference in this country. If we can spare 14 lakh rupees, we can give paid fellowships to 7 young orthopedic surgeons. I will make the women's cell active in the Indian Orthopedic Association and shall welcome their active participation in the various policies and programs of our association. I have enough time to work for the welfare of the members of the association, and I do want that there should be accountability on our part and there should be transparency on the part of the office bearers of the Indian Orthopedic Association.
Sir, what is your message for Indian Orthopedic Association today?
Your vote is precious and you must cast your vote. Your vote is for your own welfare. You must post your ballot yourself. Your vote is for the change, and you choose the best candidate for the post of Vice President of Indian Orthopedic Association. Change is always better. Let us together make Indian Orthopedic Association the best association in the world, and that is what is my dream. Thank you very much.